All right, so I've been following this wilderness boundary right here. This, according to my, maps, yeah, follows the Tidewater and Tonopah Railroad, which used to be here. It's pretty much the delineator there between Dumont Dunes and the wilderness here. So all that way is wilderness. And this way over here is the off-highway vehicle riding area. But there wasn't much to see back there. I stopped and had lunch and sat there for a while, hoping that the wind would calm down. Nope, it's still cold and windy. So moving on, I was just following the railing down here. Finally got down to the wash. I came from that way. Dunes are out there. I'm pretty much where I started from this morning. I went all around the dunes. I'm back in the flatlands here where all the campers are. And out this way is the little canyon out here. And the train actually came through this area. You can see the ridge here. So the train followed the ridge down, went down into the canyon there, and up following the, I think it's the Armagosa River, up to Shoshone or Topeka, Tecopa. I'm not exactly sure. So I actually stopped and walked this thing to check it out and make sure it's wide enough for my truck, you know. Drive all the way out there, find out it's all eroded at the end there, and I have to back it up. You know, now I'm kind of having fun. Because I don't want to tear up my truck in the dunes. I mean, I was able to drive out there in the sand at 20 PSI, but to really get into the dunes, I'd have to air down a lot more. And, you know, I got it loaded down with stuff. I just don't want to beat my truck out there going up and down sand hills. I'm happy being here. This is much more interesting. It's a lot warmer. I'm burning up now. I like this. I think I'm gonna continue on. Like I said, this is Sperry Wash. If you're looking at off-road trails book I got, California Off-Road Trails, this is Sperry Wash route. And I did this, I'd say it was last year. I came up Kingston Wash, stopped at the Krusty Bunny Ranch, and came around the mountains there, what's that, Kingston Range, all the way back. I got here at the beginning of this route about maybe 7-8 o'clock at night, and I drove this solo at night all the way through back to the entrance of Dumont Dunes. And my plan was to stay at the dunes, so I turned to the dunes there and they wanted like $40. I'm like, forget that, I'll just keep on going. And I ended up camping out at Ibex, which was nice, which is cool. This is it, a place to be, right? Time for a cold one. All right, a little farther down the trail. It sure is nice out here. Now, I'm gonna kick these shoes off only because my shoes are wet. Oh, it stays like this, perfect. I just wanted to show you the railroad, the route, I guess you'd call it. Look across the mountains over there, you can see the ridge. Goes across, there's a little breach. There's a little breach right there where it got washed out and goes across, keeps going all the way over there, goes across all the way over there. I can see why the trail is closed, because it's washed out in places, so you can't follow it with a vehicle. But you can't follow it down here, there ain't nothing to see anyway. This is cool, this is what I like doing. I found the dunes to be a little boring back there. This is a lot nicer. Everything's different. Terrain changes a little bit here and there. I hear some bikes or something coming down from over there. Well, I figure I'd stop here. Kick off my wet shoes. I don't think I'll be getting off anymore. I got my flip-flops, and if it gets cold again, well, I'll just put shoes on. I got some other shoes too. Not as cold as it was this morning. Where's that you? That water kind of feels good.